What's up guys, this is Hot Eye 7 RCT bringing you another gaming related video, and today we're going to be bringing the one and only Manticore Galaxy on Fire for the Switch. Now, I already had an unfiltered recently where I spoke about the weird release window for this game and how it got delayed for several days with no apparent reason whatsoever, and today we're going to be covering the gameplay of it. So yeah, straightforward, right to the point. This is a mobile phone game that has been ported by brought to you by Deep Silver. So we're gonna go here into the gameplay screen. Already have this set up here. So let's go into there, and let me bring down here the legend, Ronnie James Dio. May you rest in peace. We miss you so much. Yeah, so let's do this. I hope you guys are doing really well, having a great weekend, because at the time of this recording is basically Saturday for me. I have the day off, thankfully. Because my God. Now, we know Deep Silver for games like Dead Island, I believe, from 1 to 3, and some other titles. Heavy hitters, not exactly AAA, but heavy hitters nonetheless. And this, of course, is a mobile phone port. The reason why this one really caught my eye is because it's kind of like a space flight sim / Star Fox type game, where you have like arcade mechanics in a space flight simulation. First thing that I noticed right from the outset was all of the instances where there's like loading, which really didn't make me feel so good, but I'm hoping that after the game, you know, caches enough, we don't have to endure so much loading and stuff, because I really don't like that. Specifically, having, you know, a cart as a medium, you shouldn't be going through so much loading, but you know, it is what it is. Now, the main advantage of having this Switch version, even though this right here says Manticore Galaxy on Fire, they're already, I think, around 3, because the series is actually Galaxy on Fire, but it kind of took the main name of Manticore for some reason. I haven't played the other one, so I really don't know story-wise. Now, I'm seeing here that the actual title screen moves with the gyro controls. That's a nice little touch. Now, I wonder if you can use gyro controls on the game itself. Let's find out. Let's go into full screen here. Alright, so I'm going to continue just for the sake of brevity and not have to go through. See, here's our first loading. Now, this is understandable because this is like, you know, the main loading for the game. You're going to start or whatever, but look at this. Right? Still taking time.
I'm Commander Bryce Vantock, and this is my ship, the Manticore. Our skills are for hire. There's a lot of money to be made out here. If you're good with that, you're welcome to prove your worth.
Now, there was an intro sequence. Basically, that's all that's been missed here because, you know, the game has to take you by the hand and show you the ropes and stuff like that.
That's Bryce's way of saying, glad to have you on board.
A lot of important people rendezvous at a conference discussing the future of Neox. Terrans, Nevillians, Starfire, everyone. That means a lot of security is required.
I really appreciate the voiceovers, though. Seems to be pretty good. So, start mission, yeah. Pretty straightforward,
hey,
nothing to choose.
Welcome to the hangar. Your AI's busted, but the ship is fixed.
This is the only one we have so far, so let's pick it. Now, the control scheme for this one is pretty straightforward as well. And here we go with another loading. It's pretty straightforward. You have a joystick for movement. And you have that's the primary one, the left one. And then the right one, you have it kind of like Star Fox. You move it up for boost. You move it down for brakes. And actually, just like Star Fox, you move it to the sides for barrel rolls. So... yeah, it's actually pretty similar in that regard to Star Fox. Which, I know a lot of people are going to scoff at this, but I'm really, really wanting to have, out of all the ports that Nintendo could bring, I'm hoping they bring over Star Fox. I know that game, a lot of people didn't like it. I kind of loved it on the Wii U, and even with the extra game, the bonus game, with the cameras, I love that. Playing that with Afro Soul, oh my god. You check the video if you haven't seen it. So here we are.
Most of the big players are here. Nova Defense, Sentinel, they're providing security for this conference. The Terrans, Vosk, Starfire, the Nevillians. Everyone is gathering to talk about the Neox sector. Everyone wants GLOW, but they're trying to work it out so no one starts a war.
Now, one of the things that the game
promises... You'll be escorting Alexander Torque Turrington, Terran Federation rep for the conference.
Is 60 frames per second.
I'm traveling in secret to the conference. The Indigo
graphics
Brink
pirates
have been after what I'm transporting. There they are. It's not Indigo Brink. Who is that? Make sure to keep them off me.
Evading and boosting costs energy. Keep an eye on your energy bar.
Sustained.
Scans show they were Gregath pirates.
Ah, them. They've been a real nuisance lately.
Distress calls are coming in from the conference.
You heard them! Reverse course!
What's going on? Kids, stick close to that ship.
Oh, we're being torn apart! I've never seen an explosion like...
Pilots, come in. Okay, most of my pilots aren't responding.
We're okay here. But I'm getting messages about casualties. It's bad. The planet. Look what happened to the planet.
Okay. Straightforward, you got the ZL for firing rockets. Although, at this point, I still don't have any. Now, another thing that I understand is that this game, at least on the mobile phone, Android and stuff, it had a lot of microtransactions. I did not know that. But, at least here, I'm hoping that is not the case.
Kid, he should be fine for a bit. See what you can find.
Yeah.
I'm not picking up any comm chatter. It's just dead out there. The Vosk. There are so many burnt out ships.
We've got company. Looks like Gurgath pirates.
Bring it on.
How did they survive?
That doesn't matter now. Fight them off.
Oh! Yeah, at least we have arcadey gameplay because I just crashed into something and I didn't explode, so that's kind of cool.
If need be, slow down to improve aim. This makes tracking your prey easier. Boost, dodge, shoot, destroy. These are the skills of a great hunter.
Boss? That looks
there,
good.
That ship. It has the markings of a Gurgath pirate. Take him down, kid. I want answers.
Hell yeah.
What's left of his flight computer.
Greetings, Organics. I am Jaylen, advanced AI of Epicac Design.
What can you tell us about the Gurgath?
Pirates, run by a Vosk female, Shigal.
Shigal? If she was responsible for this.
So far, it's looking sweet.
I have to get back to HQ. The Terran Federation is in disarray. Everyone is panicking. A lot of people are dead, kid. Good men and women. People I flew with for a long time. We need to look through this data. Figure out a plan. Find Shigal. Bring it back home, kid.
All right. That was simple enough.
Now, kid, you've proven your worth. I lost most of my other pilots. I need you to fly point for a while. Seems people are already calling this disaster the Shattering, saying it was a mining accident. I don't buy it. At least Indigo Brink, those bastards, were wiped out in the disaster. They deserve nothing less after what happened to Haley. If we're gonna catch up with Shigal and her Gurgath pirates, we need to keep active. Jaylen, the AI we found, helped us to create this layout of the Gurgath gang. Let's have a look.
So far, they're hooking me in with the story. And I'm seeing on the screen here, profile codex.
Putting Jaylen in your ship's computer, as Saya tells me, your old AI is fried.
I look forward to you exploding, much like my former owner, Organic.
Oh shit. That's cute. Well, no way to go back. So far, it's pretty straightforward. But I'm seeing a lot of RPG elements, which I think I'm going to appreciate. So yeah, I gotta say the game is pretty good. I'm kind of wondering why the file size gravitates around 3 gigs, just 2 point something. There's a lot of voice overs, and the graphics seem to be pretty good. I mean, they're not like groundbreaking, you know, current gen graphics by any means, but they are pretty good. Surprising for the file size.
Kid, I normally wouldn't send you on a mission this important, but most of my other pilots are dead. Don't screw it up. Starfire Survey is having trouble with some pirates that call themselves Grigath. Apparently it's Vosk, for Haint. It's interrupted their Glow mining operation. So Martha Penbury here, a Starfire rep, hired us as an escort.
Bryce, I keep telling you, call me Mary. We just need a watchdog till we hit the gate. Stay close and we'll look after each other. Hull breach. Can't tell which deck.
Now I wonder, let me check here the controls to see if you can actually use... Now that's kind of weird. You have on the title screen, you can actually move with the gyro controls, but you don't have that option to actually use it. Huh. Well, that's that. Let's go back to this mission.
Can you scan it for us?
Oh, but there's a cool little thing called action freeze. All right, you just go in and you freeze exactly where you are. And you can just zoom in and check. There you go. In here, you can tell a bit better how the graphics look. They look pretty sharp. Have some reflection and stuff like that. Pretty nice. Let's go ahead and try and do this mission.
Fly in close to the breach to scan it. That's the Grigath pirates now. Keep them off us if you can. Company.
Probability of victory is high because the enemy is trash.
I'm liking this AI already. Alright, almost got you, almost got you. There you go. Nice. Where's the other one?
Flying so far. You're the new kid with Manticore, right?
Refrain from over-complimenting my pilot.
Oh, shit.
Result in hotshot antics.
Strange AI. I have a mouth on it. I like it.
Just like I do, yep. You're absolutely right. It's an AI with an attitude. And she seems like the jealous type, too.
We have another hull breach. Can you help us out again? More company. We've sustained more damage. Find the breach for us.
Exceeding predicted performance levels, but only by 10%.
Don't listen to that AI. You're looking good out there.
Boss fight. Let's do this.
Ignore the organic. Listen to me. If you die, I die. My sensors show that Varus has flash grenades equipped. You might want to shield your eyes, or you might die blind.
A new escort, huh? It'll go the same. Surrender the loot and maybe you won't be destroyed.
That's Vahar's Tangs. Been leading the Gregoth raids.
Show that pirate scum what we do to their kind.
Don't be cocky, pilot. You are still new. Fly with caution.
Bring down that shield. There was a power up there. I want to get the boss. Where the hell is the boss? All right. Let's get these little dogs first. Have a shield. There's a chance. I don't give a fuck if you blind me. I'm still gonna be on your ass. Don't let her recharge the shield.
My assessment of your skills was incorrect. I will readjust.
Good job, kid. Martha? Who's this Drac?
You'll never call me Mary, will you? Drac is a mid-level Gregoth thug. Uses signal jammers. Makes it hard to lock on in a fight. Known to run glow-infused explosives.
All right. Mission complete.
Found a blueprint for you, boss. With blueprints, I know how to build pretty much everything.
So more weapons and more missions will be available, of course.
Manticore's hangar, a sight to behold. Let's equip another primary weapon.
But I'm gonna be doing this stuff later on. All I can say is that the gameplay is pretty awesome. It's let's say it's a bit more than I was expecting, to be honest. So I am definitely pleasantly surprised with this game. So yeah, I mean, for $20, it's not really that bad. Granted, it's a mobile phone game port, but a good one at that, at least for now. I see that the controls, they feel pretty fluid. I mean, they did promise that it was going to be 60 frames per second, and they seem to have done good on their promise. So yeah, this is a good showing for Deep Silver, even with the whole hiccup of the delay, the last minute delay that never was explained why. It has nice voiceovers, great control, arcade style shooting, space kind of shooting. And yeah, I think I can fill the void of the arcade type, Star Fox type shooter on the system. So yeah, go for it guys, pretty good game. And this will be all for today. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And if not, at least please give it a share. A small YouTuber here trying to, you know, make it. And see you guys later. Take care and peace. You stole